Hello everyone, welcome back. Here in this presentation, we'll be continuing with the digestive system of Pila globosa, the apple snail. We have already seen the alimentary canal. We saw that the digestive system, it is composed of alimentary canal and the digestive glands. And in the previous presentation, we looked into the detail on the structure parts of the alimentary canal. Okay, here we are going to deal with the digestive glands as well as the process of digestion. Here you can see in the case of digestive glands, you can see one is the esophageal pouch, another is buccal ganglion associated with the buccal cavity, then another set of salivary glands again found associated with the buccal cavity. And as already mentioned, there is a digestive gland which opens into the stomach at the junction between the pyloric and the cardiac stomach. Okay, we will look into in detail. The buccal glands, they are actually glandular areas on the roof of the buccal cavity, found on the roof of the buccal cavity. There are a pair of glandular areas, or there are a pair of buccal glands usually associated a little in front of the junction between buccal glands, buccal cavity and the esophagus. Okay, so where the buccal cavity opens into the esophagus, somewhere very anterior to that, on the roof of the buccal cavity, you can see the buccal glands, a pair of buccal glands situated. Okay, and the secretions of the buccal glands, it is believed to be like involved in carbohydrate digestion. Even the buccal glands, it is believed to secrete mucus. So mucus helps in actually grinding the food along. Okay, a movement of the food through the alimentary canal, etc. Now the next one, it is the salivary glands. Again, there are two in number, and placed on either side of the posterior part of the buccal mass, that is very close to the buccal gland, a pair of salivary glands present on the roof of the buccal mass, okay, towards the posterior part. And each gland, it looks like a branching structure. Okay, you can see that the duct from each gland, a pair it is there, isn't it? So a duct from each gland, it enters the buccal mass and opens into the buccal cavity in the area of the dorsal buccal gland. Okay, as already mentioned, the salivary gland, it is very close to the buccal gland. So the duct from the salivary gland, it opens very close to the buccal gland. Okay, and the secretions from the salivary gland, it contains mucin-like substance as well as carbohydrates enzyme, that is, it is involved in the carbohydrate digestion, carbohydrate which is present inside the in the food. The mucus, it helps in lubricating the radula, the mucin like substance, and also it helps the smooth passage of food through the alimentary canal. Okay, now the next one in the series, it is the esophageal pouch. The esophageal pouch, you can see here a pair of esophageal pouch. Usually just lying below the salivary glands, and it is placed at each pouch, it opens by a narrow duct, and the duct opens at the junction between the buccal cavity and the esophagus. Okay, it opens at the junction of the buccal cavity and esophagus, and these esophageal pouches, they are believed to secrete digestive enzymes. Okay, then we have is the digestive gland, that is actually the most important among the digestive glands of Pila. It is the digestive gland, or it is otherwise known as hepatopancreas, or even the liver. It is associated with the stomach. As already mentioned, there is a gland which opens at the junction between the the cardiac and the pyloric stomach, and that is the digestive gland. Okay, it is triangular in nature, with a convex outer and more or less flattened inner surface, and we can see that it's almost partially surrounds the cardiac stomach. It is massive nature, bilobed structure. Okay, and when you look into the structure of the digestive gland or the hepatopancreas, we can see that each gland, what you call, each of the lobe, it is bilobed, two lobes form the digestive gland, and each lobe, you can see it is formed of many fine tubules, and these tubules are bound together by a connective tissue. Okay, and each tubule has a ciliated proximal part and a glandular terminal part. Okay, so you can see here that the tubules, we can see what you call the gland, it is actually formed of numerous large number of smaller tubules, and these tubules are what is referred as the alveoli, and these alveoli are connected together, or they are actually placed together, bound together by connective tissues. And each alveolus, sorry, each alveolus, if you see, it is further made up of actually the alveoli are lined with the digestive epithelium. Okay, and this epithelium, it is made up of three types of cells. I hope it is clear. Okay, the digestive gland or the hepatopancreas, they are bilobed structure. It is a bilobed structure, and each of the lobe is formed of numerous what you call tubules, okay, tube-like structures, tubules, and these are referred as alveoli. The alveoli, the inner, it is lined with like digestive epithelium, and these epithelium, it is formed of three kinds of cells: the secretory cells, resorptive cells, and lyme cells. Secretory cells, as the name suggests, it secretes cellulases, okay, cellulases or cellulose digesting enzyme. Resorptive cells, they are involved in digestion of proteins intracellularly. That is, a part of the digestion takes place inside the digestive gland, and there, the resorptive cells, it helps in the protein digestion, intracellular protein digestion. Okay, and lyme cells are involved in storing calcium phosphate. Okay, so partly digested food, it enters from the stomach, it enters the what you call the alveoli, and there the cellulose as well as protein gets digested with the help of the secretions from the secretory as well as the resorptive cells. Okay, so cellulases and proteases are present in the secretions of the digestive gland or the hepatopancreas. I hope it is clear. Resorptive cells produce proteolytic enzymes, and secretory cells, it produces cellulose digesting enzymes, and these helps in intracellular digestion of the partly digested food from the stomach, right? So this is about the digestive glands, buccal gland and salivary gland in the buccal cavity, esophageal pouches opening at the junction of buccal cavity and esophagus, digestive gland or hepatopancreas, or sometimes it is also referred as liver, it opens into the stomach. Okay, as already mentioned, hepatopancreas, it is bilobed, and it has a what you call the two lobes are unequal in size, smaller one it is remains in contact with the stomach, while the larger one it extends to the apex of the spiral. Okay, now the two separate ducts arise from these two lobes of the hepatopancreas, and then from the two lobes two ducts arise, and these two ducts unite together, it forms a common duct, and it is this common duct that opens into the stomach. Okay, and the actually the what you call the ducts inside the digestive gland, these ducts, it branches repeatedly, and it is these branching structures which are found in the what you call the digestive gland. Okay, and this lead to the alveoli. I hope that part is clear. Okay, now regarding the digestion, when you look into the digestion, the pila, they are mainly predominantly herbivorous in nature. Okay, they feed mainly on the soft and succulent aquatic vegetations, and very rarely they feed on dead animal tissues. Okay, you can see that they cut plant parts into small pieces with the help of the cuticular jaws present inside the buccal mass, and then these cut pieces, they are pushed into the buccal cavity. And these pieces are then masticated with the help of the radula. I hope you remember, in the buccal mass, there is a structure known as radula, which keep on moving backward and forward over the odontophore. Okay, so this movement, it actually helps in what you call the mastication of the pieces of the plant parts which gets inside the oral cavity. Okay, so that is the herbivorous nature. Another important feature is again the chainsaw movement. As already mentioned, the radula keeps on moving backward and forward in the buccal cavity, in the posterior part of the buccal cavity, right, over the odontophore. And this movement, it is what is known as the chainsaw movement. Okay, the chainsaw movement of the radula, it helps in taking in of the food into the buccal cavity, right, and also it helps in mastication of the food which enters the buccal cavity. Because the radula, they contain teeth-like structures, and it is being moved over the what you call odontophore, which is supported with the by a cartilaginous structure. Actually, mastication happens. Okay, so this helps in the mastication. Okay, now the movement of the radula over the odontophore, it is done with the help of many muscles like sphincter muscles, protractor muscles of the buccal mass. Okay, so all these helps in the what you call movement of radula, the opening and closing of the mouth, as well as the movement of the jaws. Okay, all these are done with the help of all the musculature associated with the buccal cavity. Fine. So the food is food entered the buccal cavity, it is masticated in the buccal cavity. Now what happens later? The first step in the digestion is the buccal digestion, or the part of the digestion which takes place in the buccal cavity. We can say that the digestion starts in the buccal cavity. Now, as already mentioned, there are salivary glands. They pour their secretion into the buccal cavity, and these secretions, as we can already see, it contains what you call carbohydrates, that is the carbohydrate digesting enzymes, and this mixes with the food and it converts the starch in the food into the sugar. Okay, so this is what happens in the buccal digestion. That is, the carbohydrate digestion gets initiated in the buccal cavity with the help of the secretions from the what you call the salivary glands. Okay, now next the digestion, it continues in the stomach. And in the stomach, the food gets digested with the help of the secretions from the digestive gland or the hepatopancreas. As already mentioned, the hepatopancreas, the secretions of the hepatopancreas contains proteases as well as carbohydrates, isn't it? So with the help of these, the digestion occurs in the stomach. But it is only partial digestion. And the digestion, the part of the digestion which takes place in the stomach, it is extracellular, because it takes place in the lumen of the stomach. Now, with the help of these enzymes, and even after the buccal digestion, part of the food may have got digested. Okay, and this semi-digested or partially digested food, it enters the digestive gland, and that is where the intracellular digestion take place. And there, what you call the digestion takes place intracellular inside the digestive gland. So digestion is completed in the stomach and in the digestive gland. Later, absorption takes place. Absorption of the food takes place mainly in the digestive gland and the intestine. And the undigested food from the what you call intestine, it is pushed into the rectum, and from there it is passed out through the anal opening into the branchial chamber of the mantle cavity. Okay, very close to the what you call the right nuchal lobe, it opens into. Okay, and it is finally expelled out along with the outgoing current of the water. So water, it enters the what you call the right mantle, the branchial chamber, through the right nuchal lobe. Okay, and water moves out of the branchial chamber through the right nuchal lobe. Okay, and this movement of water into and out of the branchial chamber, actually it is maintained for taking in food, as well as for the gaseous exchange to take place. So what happens is, when the what you call undigested part of the food, it is expelled out through the anal opening into the branchial chamber. This is expelled out along with the water, which moves out from the branchial chamber through the right nuchal lobe. Okay, so this is what happens in the digestion. I hope it is clear. We saw the feeding part. We saw the how the food passes through the alimentary canal. Okay, what are the various digestive glands associated with various points of the alimentary canal, and the cellulases and proteases being digested with the help of the secretions. Right. Thank you.